Hola amigos, bienvenidos nuevamente a su programa favorito Al Día. Hoy tenemos un invitado muy especial aquí con nosotros. Él es el nuevo presidente de la Cámara de Comercio aquí en Sioux Falls y queremos platicar con él un poquito, pero vamos a cambiarlo a inglés para que la conversación sea un poco más fluida. You're right.
I'm ready.
He's in. And so yeah, so we have Jeff Griffin here from the Chamber of Commerce, and we're gonna have a conversation. This is actually a very crazy time to have a conversation with you. You know, and I've been wanting to talk to you because I know the Hispanic community knows. They know that you're here. They know we have a new chamber person, but they haven't had a chance to hear a whole lot about you. And I know that you were super busy before and that you had other things, so I didn't really want to bug you too much. And then with this, you know, there's so much stuff going on. But before I continue, I want to thank Cabrera McKinnon for the sponsorship, Pulso Hispano, and USA Media TV. I got to throw
you
those
knew,
in there.
Of course. Thanks.
And so thank you, Jeff, for being here with us
sure.
today. We are keeping our little separation apart, just in case you guys notice. But, you know, before we get to the, you know, to the chamber and to what's going on, tell me a little bit about you. Where are you from? And how do you end up here in Sioux Falls, South Dakota?
Yeah, it's a good story. I could go on and on about that. But
the short version.
The short version, right. The short version is I'm originally from Canton, mm-hmm. Ohio, mm-hmm. and ended up in Sioux Falls because I worked for many years with abused children and so forth in a nonprofit environment for about 20 years, and I was on a city council in Worcester, Ohio.
Okay.
And then that work led me into Chamber of Commerce work, mm-hmm. and I ended up moving to Peoria, Illinois for 6 years mm-hmm. to run their chamber. And then when Sioux Falls, South Dakota called about this job being open, it was very interesting. I was very intrigued by the robust economy and the quality of life in Sioux Falls. So my wife and I explored it. And my wife, Rosie, and I have been married 24 years. She's actually the daughter of immigrants from the Dominican Republic.
Yeah, and she speaks Spanish?
She speaks
Spanish. Oh, well, we're going to have her in our show someday.
Yeah. In fact, in my previous role in Peoria, there was a Spanish festival, and she helped me translate a presentation to the crowd for our big table event.
Very nice.
So, yeah, her father came to the U.S. in the late 60s for medical mm-hmm. school and then had his medical practice in Ohio.
All right. Well, I wanna know, of course, you know, what the chamber is doing right now, what the role is for the chamber with this whole pandemic thing that's going on. But first, I wanna know, without even thinking about that right now, what was your view of the chamber, and what do you think about our chamber, and what kind of things do you think you may be able to help? Mm-hmm. To make this a little bit more friendly for the Hispanic, not only the Hispanic community, but all the diverse community in general.
Right. So what attracted me was the growth of the community over the last 20 years, because mm-hmm. That spells out opportunity. You know, that doesn't happen by accident. Mm-hmm. And in today's work environment, people can live in any area of the country they want to and really make their dreams come true. So I was really, Rosie and I were really attracted to just the vibrancy of the mm-hmm. community. And then when we visited, the warm welcome that people have heard me talk about. Specific to the growing, like all of America, mm-hmm. Growing Spanish-speaking population. Mm-hmm. And here in Sioux Falls, beyond the Spanish-speaking population, we have other populations
yes.
growing. It's becoming a more colorful place, literally,
yes,
right?
Yes.
And my initial read on that, even before we decided to move here, is that is overall welcomed. And you have pockets where that's a little slower to come about than others. But to answer your question, we need to make sure that our resources are available in all languages, which now we presently have a supportsiouxfalls.biz website. And a group did work with us, and they're able to translate that into multiple different languages.
Oh, really?
So,
would you repeat that? I'm gonna put it down
sure.
here below.
SupportSiouxFalls.biz okay. is our website. It's a microsite
okay.
Where people can go and learn what restaurant hours are presently, business-to-business services, and some legislative updates and so forth. But now,
any links for support or telephones where people can call when they need help?
So it depends on the type of help they want. Right. So any of the social service, meals, and those sort of things, we're directing that to 211, okay. The helpline, because okay. they're answering.
But how
that.
About business issues? Let's yep. say they want to try to find a loan for, you know, keeping their business going. Yep. Is that something they can find their information about?
100%.
Okay.
There's a bunch of information there. There's also an email and a phone number if you don't, you should mm-hmm. find what you need, but if you'd rather talk to someone, mm-hmm. You call in. Now we're all working remotely,
right.
So you'll get a call back within the hour,
okay.
But we can help people.
But the chamber's still responding to phone calls?
Oh, absolutely, yes.
And emails?
Emails and phone calls.
Wow, that's just, amazing.
Yeah, it's just, well, we're also, our staff are presently calling each of our mm-hmm. 2,000 members just to touch base along yeah. the way. But people leave a voicemail on that hotline, we'll call them back.
Okay, now let's fast forward to today.
All right.
Yes. How is the chamber dealing with this? What kind of things, you know, I know about the website, but yeah. what other kind of things are you talking to people about? What kind of help is there out yeah. there that you know about that has to do with the chamber?
Yeah.
And also, are you planning, do you have a plan for getting things back together once we're over this?
Yeah, so there's a lot going on with what you just asked. We've been able to connect a lot of businesses with the Paycheck Protection Program. Loan that's available through the federal government that people can apply for up to 8 weeks of their payroll taken care of. We've connected some businesses had a bunch of, there was a business that had a bunch of food sitting in a freezer that wasn't being distributed to their normal customers because of the disruption. And we were on a call with Senator Thune and that food's being redirected to people that need it. I think the government's even purchasing some of that for people in need. Wow. So making those connections. We're not disrupting our normal activities in terms of we're not having in-person meetings and so forth, mm-hmm. but we're moving that into GoToMeeting and Zoom as much as possible. Mm-hmm. And that's actually, you know, as traumatic as this crisis is, because we're dealing with real death across our nation,
yes.
and it's very emotional for the nation. But we're trying to gather groups electronically that have, I know my staff today got together for lunch at GoToMeeting.
Really?
Yeah. And
that's,
you know,
good.
Just trying to keep their spirits up. And I know that's been happening with the young professionals
yeah.
and so forth. So we have things canceled through April,
okay.
and our staff working remotely through April. Mm-hmm. We've talked about some sort of catch-all event or fun mm-hmm. event once this is all over, because mm-hmm. you know we've had to cancel the St. Patrick's mm-hmm. Day Parade. I know Experience Sioux Falls had to cancel their luncheon.
Yeah.
Things have been canceled. So hopefully when this is all over, we can have a hodgepodge event.
A big party!
A big party! And get everyone together for something very fun.
And so there you have it, my friends. But more important than anything, join your chamber. This is your chamber of commerce, right?
That's exactly
any,
correct.
Any
we
last,
need your help.
Last messages for our
no,
viewers?
No, no. Other than thank you, those of you in the community working hard, keep your chin up, stay healthy, and any support you can give the chamber helps us take care of the whole community.
All right, well, I will shake your hand.
I know, right?
But
peace, brother.
All right, stay with us. Quédense con nosotros. Regresamos después de estos mensajes.